is Brian Chitsey, and this is my informative speech. Mozart, Howard Hughes, David Beckham, and Billie Eilish. These are names that are known by many, but what do they all have in common? They all have Tourette syndrome. Tourette syndrome is a disorder that has not been talked about very much and has been given a false stereotype in the media. I want to eliminate the need for this stereotype. Today, I will be answering three frequently asked questions about Tourette syndrome. What is it? Are there different types of Tourette syndrome? And what does it look like to be a person living with Tourette's? What is Tourette syndrome? Tourette syndrome is a neurodevelopmental disorder. Neuro means that it occurs in the brain and nervous system. Developmental means that it occurs and changes as the brain and nervous system grow. So what occurs in the body that is different for someone with Tourette syndrome? There are chemicals in the brain and the body that act as messengers and stop signs. When someone wants to raise their hand, the messengers run from the brain to the arm and the hand and tell them to move. When someone wants to stop raising their hand, the messengers stop. This is not what happens to someone with Tourette's. The messengers and stop signs in their body don't pay attention to each other. This causes a person to experience what is known as a tic. Doctors define a tic as an involuntary, sudden, rapid, repetitive movement or sound. Tourette syndrome is a common medical condition. In their research, doctors have discovered that one out of every 160 children between the ages of 5 and 17 in the United States has Tourette syndrome. One out of every 100 children between the ages of 5 and 17 in the United States has Tourette syndrome or another tic disorder. About half of the children in the United States with Tourette syndrome go undiagnosed. There are multiple types of Tourette and tic disorders. The most basic types of tics are simple motor and vocal tics. Simple motor tics means that the tics only use one group of muscles. This includes blinking, jaw movements, head bobbing, and shoulder shrugging. Simple vocal tics consist of sounds, such as sniffing, throat clearing, and grunting. There are also complex motor and vocal tics. Complex motor tics involve multiple muscle groups or combinations of movement and may seem intentional. Examples of this would include jumping up and down and sticking out your tongue. Complex vocal tics include words or phrases that may or may not be recognizable, but that occur out of context. This might include repeating words or phrases. In addition to simple and complex tics, there are four special types of complex tics. These tics are usually how the media portrays anyone with Tourette's, even though they only occur in extreme cases. Coprolalia is saying words or phrases that can be obscene or socially inappropriate. Copropraxia is making obscene or socially inappropriate gestures. Echolalia is repeating words or phrases said by others. Palilalia is repeating one's own words. While these may seem intentional, these complex tics are uncontrollable. Neurologists are still researching the different types of tics and tic disorders and what might cause them. Finally, what does it look like to live with Tourette syndrome? I have Tourette's. Throughout most of my early life, I felt different and was bullied for something I couldn't control. I felt secluded and I didn't have many friends. This is the story of most people with Tourette syndrome. It wasn't until I went into high school that I understood that I wasn't that different. I made friends that accepted me, and I knew that what I had wasn't a bad thing. Tourette's isn't something that we can control, even if we may want to. While there is a lot of information that is known about Tourette's syndrome, there is still so much that is unknown. I hope that today I have at least been able to raise awareness so that we can come together to learn more about this syndrome.